Welcome to World of Warcraft. I know this isn't World of Warcraft, it looks like a fuzzy board, but that's okay, that's because we're going to do a quick history lesson. And the history lesson is a quick and dirty timeline for Pandaren and other new players. So, when you start the game up, there's two things you have to bear in mind. The first thing you have to bear in mind is the expansion release history. In other words, World of Warcraft is a big game, and it released a lot of extra content through add-on discs that you can buy. And then you install them and they get sort of clutched onto the game. In the beginning, there was what we know now as classical vanilla, and that was just 1 to 60. There was no real storyline, really. You just roamed around the world and killed things and life was good. Then they had the Burning Crusade, which is 60 to 70. Basically, this is World of Warcraft in space, and also you are not prepared. After that, we have Wrath of the Lich King, which takes the story from Warcraft 3, the story of Arthas and how he went crazy, and it solves that story. It puts it right at large, and in the end, you deal with what happened there. If you haven't played Warcraft 3, it won't make any sense, but anyway, the end boss is the Lich King, and everyone was real excited about that. The Lich King showed up everywhere and everything, and it was just a bit of a problem that way, but that was 70-80. So then what happened was, the game at this point is like about 8 years old or something. No, 6 years old or so. And they decided that they needed to revamp the game. So they went back to the 1 to 60 areas and they fixed them up and they made them better using the quest technology and the lessons that they learned. What this means is that the old version, the classic vanilla version of the game, is not really in there anymore at all. There's hints of it in the zone design and in some of the quests, but the actual game doesn't function a lot like it did in those early days at all. They also released some 80 to 85 content, which was spread all over the world of the original World of Warcraft, the two continents, Eastern Kalimdor and the human land and the Horde land, Kalimdor and the other place, Eastern Kingdoms, and so you got to go there from 80 to 85. Then we have Mists of Pandaria, which is kind of what we've been playing a little with the Wandering Isle. That took the pandas that were like a throwaway joke in Warcraft 3 and made them part of the game. Lots of people got frustrated at this. I really liked the idea of it. I didn't like the execution. Then we have Warlords of Draenor. I don't like Warlords of Draenor at all. The less we say about that, the better. It's all orcs all the time, and you go back 35 years in Warcraft's history in an alternative universe. It's really silly. But, now, the problem is that if you play a Pandaren, weird things happen. The first thing that happens to you is that you play the Wandering Isle. So that's Mists of Pandaria. That's the timeline that you're in, okay? You're playing in the 85 to 90 timeline. Then what happens is you get out into the world and you experience the original World of Warcraft as it was back in the Cataclysm times. Not in the vanilla times, in Cataclysm times. So there's lots of stuff that is broken as a result of the Cataclysm. And you'll see mentions to a particular dude every now and then, and that is the Cataclysm. Then you go from there to the Burning Crusade, which is further back than Cataclysm. So you're going backwards in time, okay? And you go to Burning Crusade, and you do that. Then you come forward a little bit in time, and you do Wrath. Now, from 70 to 85, the timeline is normalized. In other words, what you're seeing actually happens one after each other. Then we have the World Until 85, which is, like I said, just the from Cataclysm to Cataclysm again, but with a gap in between, okay? So now everything is normalized, and then you get Pandaria after that, so it's all sort of okay, and then after that you get Warlords of Draenor. So if you're confused about the timeline, this is the slide you care about. There we go. Like, this really is the World of Warcraft. So the one of the new things is that there's an adventure guide to view recommended activities for you. So if you click on that and you look at this, it will tell you things that you can do. So for example, We could go to Westfall, we could get a profession, or we could go and do Warsong Culture. We're not going to do that. But what you might want to do, for example, is we might want to pick up that. We can't do any of these yet, but we will be able to soon. So we're going to start this quest. We can do any of these three, in fact. We can do Bloodmist Isle, we can do secondary professions. I think that what we're going to do, actually, we're going to take Darkshore. Nah. We'll take Westfall. Okay. Heroes call Westfall. By order of His Royal Highness King Bane, when all able-bodied citizens of the Alliance are to report to Lieutenant Horatio Lane at Jensen's stead. Westfall has been overrun by beggars and transients, leading to a massive increase in criminal activity. Your help is needed to restore order to the populace. You can reach the Jansen Stead in Westfall by traveling west from Elwyn Forest. With the glory and honor of the Alliance, report to Lieutenant Horatio Lane at the Jansen Stead in Westfall. Okay, so let's head out. I am along the way, we're gonna... Oh, wait, I'm a little lost, aren't I? Yes, I am. Oh, no. Along the way, I am going to go and pick up... Well, we might not do it here. We might do it... Actually, let's just take a bit of a trip and have a bit of an adventure. Because... Really, I mean... There's a whole big world for us to explore. Also, I like I said, I don't know where anything is. This is Stormwind City, and I am bad with Stormwind City. But we'll find ourselves a guard, and we'll go pick up some professions. Okay. So, we are looking for a guard. Oops. That will tell us things. Why is this person lying down? Oh, they're looking at the sky. Dear. Okay. Here's a guy who can tell us where things are. Okay, so these guys, what they'll do is they will you can look at them, and they will tell you where things are. Like for example, profession trainers. There's lots of professions. We are gonna take. Tailoring. A tailor is it? Well, if you hang out here long enough, you'll eventually hear word of mouth about Giorgio Bolero. He's been setting the trends for some months now. If you wish to learn from him, you can find him over at the Mage Quarter in the Outer Rim.
Be careful.
Okay, let's have a look. The Mage Quarter in the Outer Rim. He is not on my map. No, he is. He's over there. I can see him. Okay, so let's go grab tailoring. I should actually leave all the chat channels because they're just going to get nowhere as long as we're in the city. Okay, I think this is how I can get there. Yes, it is, in fact. That's a mailbox. We'll talk about mail later. We won't talk about it now. I don't have any mail, so there's no point in discussing it. I think I can go here. And from here... Yeah, this looks like a trade district, but I think I can just run straight through the trade district to get to the outer room, the mage district. This is not efficient at all. goodness. Okay. Here's what we're looking for. I dimly remember this guy because I remember doing vanilla. I bought a yellow shirt pattern from him and then had to sell it to myself at great expense. But that was a long time ago. I don't even know if he has that pattern anymore or if it even exists in the game. Okay, so here we are, we're at the Mage Quarter, and this guy should be right here. There.
What can I do for you?
Okay. I would like to do apprentice tailoring, please. That's going to cost me 10 silver, which is fine. Train. Yes.
Go with honor, friend.
Okay, we're not going to actually do any tailoring yet. I just want to pick it up because that will make life a little bit simpler. But tailoring is a profession, and you can only have two professions. Two main professions. There are little secondary professions that you can have as many of as you like. But with tailoring, you make clothes and bags, and that's the reason why we're taking tailoring, so that I can make bags myself. Because otherwise, it's just not worth it. Okay, so the other thing I want to do is get out of the city. And I think to do that, I can go... No, not here. Not at all, actually. It is, because we're in a trade district and we need to be in the city. Wait, really? Wait a minute. Hold on. That is out. Oh, goodness. What I want to do before we actually... You'll notice I cleaned up my bags. I want to get a whole lot of cloth before we do anything with tailoring. Because tailoring is kind of boring to watch. In fact, all of the professions are boring to watch, so... I don't want to do too much of that while you're watching. I'll show you the first couple and then we'll do it all off screen. Okay, so if we get out of here, we're going to end up in a zone. Now, this is L1 Forest. Now, the thing is that the way zones work is there's two kinds of zones. Zones are either outside and kind of in the world, like this one, or they're in their own little instance. When we were doing Mr. Pandaria content with the Wandering Isle, that was all instanced. We literally just... it was a little space in the wall set apart for just the people who were in Pandaria at the time, and they were working together to do the Wandering Isle content. This part of the world, though, is not instanced, which means that anyone can be here regardless of their level. And it's not set apart just for those, like a couple of specific people. We're sinking to the bottom. Oh, silly panda. My plan, literally, is just to run us towards where we need to be, and then we'll start questing from there. I am even not really paying attention to these people. Okay, so if you're wondering why some of these people have little paw marks above them, they are pet battles, and that's something I will show from, like, in an interlude, probably. Because they're not, like, they're interesting, but they're not the main focus of what we're doing here. We are leveling really slowly because I am running. That problem will get solved eventually, don't worry. Yay, I spot a quest, but I'm not going to do that because that's not where we're going. That's part of the zone. Oh, here we go, there's a bridge here. Okay. Oh, there's something creepy happening there. Welcome to Westfall. Okay. It's a bloodbath, Lieutenant. They've been murdered. And hello, there's another player. Given the body temperature, I'd say they've been dead no more than 6 hours. Damn shame what they did to old Blanchy. No kidding, Wookie. Looks like they really put the cart before the horse. That was such a bad joke. What happened to us? We're in worse shape now than when the fires run amok. Yep, the King Baron is good for nothing. Let's get out of here before they try and pin this on us. Good call. Those are a bunch of drifters. And then they head off. Okay, so old Blanchy used to be a horse that used to roam between here and I think the rest of Westfall. I never did a lion, so I'm not really sure. Someone can tell me about that. But basically, they killed old Blanchy when it did Cataclysm.
King's
and
honor,
their the owner, okay, I think, Murder Wookie, that's what we're looking at in the garden in front of us.
Light bless you.
Murder was the case that they gave me. Here's the deal, kid. We got a full-blown murder on our hands. Double homicide, single horse aside. Worse yet, we're in Westfall. I could throw a rock behind me and hit a dozen hobos with motive enough to want to wipe these people and horse out. Now, I don't know who did this, and I sure don't appreciate having to come to this dump to investigate the deaths of a couple of squatters, but I'll be damned if I don't find a perp. You want to help? Go talk to some bums. The hobo knows. Okay, so we're going to get some green gear. Some of this will be good for us, but most of it probably won't.
For the Alliance.
Okay. So, we're going to look for clues. And I think there's a clue. Oh, there is a clue here. Evidently. Oh, I gotta talk to the hobos, of course. Oh, the big hero's arrived. I'm saved. Yeah, right. Did you see who killed the four bows? Maybe a couple of copper will loosen your tongue. Now tell me, did you see who killed the four bows? Listen, pal, I don't want any trouble, okay? I didn't see who murdered him, but I sure heard it. Lots of yelling, human voices. You dig? Now, get out of here before I change my mind about beating you up and taking your shoes. Okay. Uh-oh. Now you've gone and done it. Time for the first. Jackpot. Oh no. Oh. Ragamuffin's all busy, like, looting his corpse. I'm not telling you a damn thing. Evidently, if they say that they will talk to you if you've got coin, then they actually mean it. And yes, me busy beating up on the hobos. Oh dear. Okay, so far we're getting nowhere fast. Oh, okay, well, let's give him some copper. 2 copper. The only thing I'll tell you was to get the hell out of here. Oh, great. It's a trap. I like it when that happens. What do you want? I didn't see you kill them, but I got a good whiff. Smelled rich, kind of like you. Damn shame too. Four bars were a fixture around here. Nice people. I go to a small rich, kind of like you. Damn shame too. Full bars are a fixture around you. Nice people. Always willing to share a meal or a patch of dirt. Stormwind says, get off my property! I told you to pay up, pal. But I don't want to lose my copper. All the money is good. I am disarmed. That's okay, I don't fight with arms. I fight with magic. Oh. I was kind of hoping, because he didn't have an aggressive tone there, that I would get information out of him. Ah, well. Get lost. On the plus side, we're getting a whole lot of experience. Oh, I was facing the wrong way. Oh no, really? I must be robbed by the defiance. At least they leave me a little something to eat from time to time. The defiance were previously the people who were in the zone. I told you to pay up, pal. Wow, this is going really slowly. I am surprised. Let's talk to this person. I'm not telling you a damn thing. Oh, these people. They're making my life so hot. Okay. Oh, she ran away, or they ran away and then came back, which is why I can't do anything. Living like an animal is hard enough without your insults. Hey, I didn't insult you. I just wanted to ask you stuff. Okay. Wow. All I want is clues. On the plus side, the combat is fairly fast, so that is good. Who killed the full boss? I'll tell you who killed the full boss. King Varian Run, that's who. And he's killing the rest of us too, one bum at a time. The only thing I can tell you is that I saw some gnolls leaving the place a few hours before the law arrived. You seem reasonable, let's talk to you. No, you're not reasonable. He was wondering if he could eat rocks, so I thought he might be reasonable. Okay. Between you and me and the tree, Murlocs killed the full boss. Yep, saw him with my own two eyes. Think they've been casing the joint for days, maybe months. They left in a hurry once they got wind of Johnny Law and the idiot brigade over there. That's good, thank you. That's all I wanted, was four clues. Oh, now you can't talk to them. I thought they were going to go, but they don't. I thought this was phased, but it's not.
Well met.
Gnolls and Murlocs? Horse poopy, pal. Gnolls and Murlocs didn't kill these people. I've seen what gnolls and murlocs do to people that kill, they kill, and this isn't it. Too pretty, too perfect. Furthermore, the Fulbrows have been squatting on the farm for 5 years. No, whoever wiped them out had a reason. This is murder plain and simple, and we're gonna get to the bottom of it. Okay, so we can pick that, but it's only got marginally better stats and strength, and I'm not interested in stats, in strength. It's got intellect and stamina, which is pretty good. And a little bit more armor. And this has got agility, we'll take that. How much more armor is this? Just one. And it's got agility, yeah, we'll take that. Okay.
Be careful.
Hot in the trail, the River Ballpark clan, and hot in the trail, the Murlocs. Watch your footing, rookie. Seeing as how we have no other leads, we may as well chase down the information you got. There are a couple of Riverpool Knoll camps in the area. Track them down and search for clues. Bring back anything that you might find. Isolate your search to the Riverpool Knolls and Scouts. Okay.
Go with honor, friend.
As pointless as I think this is going to be, we need to investigate all our leads. I need you to head out to the longshore, west of here, on the coast, and shake up some Murlocs. Try to find a clue or some info that can help shed light on the murders. Return to me if you get lucky, rookie.
For the Alliance.
Let's wear that. Okay. I'm gonna take us there, but I don't think we're gonna get anything done, because trying to extract information took a while. Actually, hold on. I think we're pretty close to leveling, and if we can do that, that would be good in this video, because that will mean something happened. Well, let's get a level quickly. I scored some real life police quest 2 points again. I am level 13. I didn't get anything for that. Okay. So this is the point where we're supposed to find that clue. What we'll do tomorrow is we'll search for the clue. And see if we can find it. And the other clue, and then we'll head back. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, lostwolfe. This has been World of Warcraft Episode 10. I will see you tomorrow. Have a great day, folks, and goodbye.